Hello guys! In this video you can watch a game of Korean Master Kasadin on middle lane. He played against counter pick. His team was so behind, and I guess they wanted to use surrender. But this Kasadin got some farm, got some kills, and after that he so carried the game. How he did it, you can find answer in this video. Let's go! Okay, Kasadin will play on middle lane against Vega. He's from 5 seconds below. Conqueror, Princess of Mind, Legion Tenacity, Cup the Grace, Bone Plate, Navi Grow, Princess Ability Powers, and Armor. He'll stay against Eevee Vega. It's hard for Kasadin because Vega is AD champion. And Kasadin is very good against AP matchups because he has his Q and passive. But against AD champions, it doesn't work. So he sucks in early game against this pick. And now as you can see he is trying to farm very safe. And Viega has more damage in early game. Also he has sustain. So it's very hard to win a lane in early stage for Kasadin. But I think after level 6 he can try to do something. But not now. So he just trying to farm under his star with his W. He started from W because it helped him to last hit these creeps. But look at this, he missed a lot of creeps. It's not good, but fine. Also he with ignite, it's pretty strange because in Korea a lot of people wanna get teleport on Kasadin, but this player got ignite. Those means he wanna try to get some kill. It's very interesting. I'm gonna try to outplay this Viega. It will be very hard. But I think maybe he can do this. Also, enemy Viega started with cool. I can understand because he's standing against Kasadin and he's weak. But Kasadin can poke you very easily with his Q and E. And look at HP of Viega. He lost half HP. And Kasadin with ignite can try to do something against this. And the new Viego, he's just teleport on the bottom lane. He killed Jinx. So in this time, Kasadin can try to push this wave. After this, after that, he can use recall. Yeah, he has enough time. So he'll push this wave and you'll use recall to the base to get some item. Enemy jungler was there. So it's fun. Kasadin is like Kayle, but Kayle is like ADC, but Kasadin is Slayer. So in the late game, Kasadin I think can turn game to his side very easily, because he deals a lot of damage with his ultimate and spells. Especially his ultimate deals really so much damage. And this spell has short cooldown. So Kasadin in the late game has insane mobility and damage. And Kayle only has damage. Yeah, she has W that gives her move speed. But it's not enough. You can go through wall without flash. But Kasadin can go across the map very easily with his ultimate. So this is difference between Kayle and Kasadin. Also I think Kasadin is stronger in the early game than Kayle, because she can do anything against strong picks. And Kasadin has very good damage in early stage with his E passive. I mean W. Look at this Viega. He tried to fight against this Kasadin, but his EQ W on the Viega. Oh, and this damage was really very good. So you can see that I think really Kasadin strong in an early game. And now look at this Viega. Oh, this Kasadin got level 6 and Viega at low HP, he trying to sustain. No, I thought, oh my god, this play was so sick. Oh my god, he's his ultimate flash after E ignite. This was so fast, so enemy Viega didn't react on the, and he died from Kasadin. So it's so bad for Viega to die for Kasadin in early stage. It's so bad. So now our Kasadin got killed, and look at these guys. Kasadin got killed. And now he coming for top lane. Hikarim at 4 HP, but Gwen at low HP, so she's free kill for Kasadin. And look at this, when I try to kill her. Oh, I think better to go to this way. Oh, he trying to deal damage. Oh, he missed his ultimate. She was there, but he's his ultimate on this place. So he missed his ultimate. And Gwen survived. Oh, it's not good play. But it's fun. Oh, look at this Lucian. 0-4-0 on the Lucian top lane. Oh my god. This is literally winner. But I think enemy Hikari maybe tried to babysit top lane. But anyway, Lucian 0-4-0, it's so bad. And Kasadin have to carry this game, oh my god. His bot lane also sucks. Jungler just nothing. And only he can do something in this game. Oh, enemy Viega, he lost his W. Oh, this damage. And Nunu? No, he don't wanna go. But this Viega, look at this damage from Kasadin. Like I said, KO can do same things in the early game. Like Kasadin. And also look at his build. He got only Dark Seal for the damage. And another items, this is additional mana and armor. Nothing on for damage. Just only Dark Seal. And this is his base damage, is really so insane. And this karma coming so strange, there was enemy Hikarim. And his team trying to get this herald. So they will try to fight. Yeah, they will try to fight, but Nuno already got this herald. So Kasadin wanna just push this wave, and after that he can use recall to the base to get item. But yeah, no, look at this, he wanna try to catch someone. No, no, he using his recall to the base. So it's pretty strange build for Kasadin. Look at this, he got plated steel caps. He got this mail for armor, and damage is only Dark Seal. It's pretty strange build, but he has a lot of armor. And he did very good damage, but look at this one. He don't wanna go to the middle lane. He wanna help for top lane. Oh, this Nunu. Oh, and also there was Hikarim. But he just ignoring this, and he gonna try to kill this Gwen. Yeah, he got shot down, so it's worth. And now this Hikarim with Viega trying to get Vyump. Oh, this damage from ultimate of Vyump was so insane. And now this Viega. Oh, he used his flash. Cause he tried to get this Kasadin, but this build for Kasadin works, guys. Damage from Hikarim and Viega not enough to kill this Kasadin. He survived and killed them. Oh, it was really insane, guys. So this build works. Oh, now he got additional armor and mana. Glacial Buckler. So it means when I go for the Frozen Heart first item, it's new current build on the Kasadin. First item, Frozen Heart. Yeah, Frozen Heart, I think, pretty good item for Kasadin. Because it gives him armor, mana, and ability haste. Oh, there was Hikarim and Karma. But Cass again survived, and now they trying to kill this Viega anyway! And this Viega died again. Oh, they has not enough damage to kill this Cass again with this build. Ooh, guys, really, this build works? Keep playing, guys, AD mid lane and AD jungle, so... This build is really so insane, and enemies just can't kill him. It's really very interesting build. So it means if you can first pick Cass again, enemy can think, I'll play against Cass again. I need to pick some AD champion. You pick this, something like Viega, Zed or something, and you can build this build, and this will be insane. They has not enough damage to kill you, but you did damage, not bad. He can set teleport. So it's good. Now he got frozen heart. Oh, 80 armor, 400 mana, 200 ability haste. I mean 20 ability haste. Oh, it also this item reduce attack speed and damage. Oh, this Herald was good. He got 2 plates, and now they wanna fight for the Drake. The swim damage of his Q and smite really insane. And this Cass again is like a fear in the jungle. Oh my god, he clearing this creep so fast with his E and ultimate. And also look at this guys. He maxed his E. Because he's stayed against AD champion. And to max his Q, this is useless because this magic shield isn't good against Viega. And also E is good choice because you can push your wave very fast. Look at this Viega, he can't do anything against this Cass again. He has insane a lot of armor. And he don't care about tower. Oh, he wanna get this tower, and after this he can try to get this. Oh, last time of ultimate. Oh, this was on cooldown, so enemy Viega use his ultimate to escape this from Cass again. But damage really guys so insane. Viega still under his tower. Gonna try to heal this Gwen. Gwen wanna get this tower. So now he trying to get this. But Gwen is pretty fat. Yeah, he has not enough damage. He built in full armor build. So he has not enough damage to one shot Gwen. And it's not good. So this is one disadvantage of this build. You has not enough damage to one shot someone, you has only poke damage. So with this build you can't function someone. You just playing like poker. Oh, this Hikarim. Oh, look at this duel between Hikarim and Cass again. Oh, this damage was from Israel ultimate. And finally he got this Hikarim, but there was enemy Israel, Karma and Viega. It's so strange, but you saw guys, Hikarim is dead. Cause Cass again, so much armor and he used damage. It's not the same damage like with Luden and Sorcerer Shows. I think with these items he would kill this Hikari much faster, but without these plated steel caps and frozen heart he would die much faster too. So maybe this build works. Oh, he playing against 3 Divine Thunderers on Hikari, Yeg and Israel. Pretty interesting. Oh, and enemy Viega, he's on the bottom lane. And this is free kill. And boom! Additional kill for the Kasajin. So good. And enemy on the top lane. Oh, they're using hero, so they need to use to go to the base. Cause enemy don't wanna stop, and with hero they can try to get inhibitor. So it will be not good. But Nunu, Thresh and Jinx coming. No, they don't wanna go. So it's good. But soon we will respawn Drake, so they will try to fight for the Drake. And with this build, oh, look at this, his second item with Riftmaker. This is additional sustain for the Kasajin. It's pretty strange. Well, sustain. But maybe it's worked. More sustain, more survivability. So maybe it's good. This ultimate deals pretty good damage. And also E deals very good damage. This is not too much, but with this tanky build, this is pretty enough. Yeah, enemy team trying to fight. They fight for this dragon. Someone is killing port on the bottom ward. And our Kasajin gonna try to pick up someone. Oh, enemy karma is here, Shurelia. Oh, he gonna go to the flank. The enemy flank. He coming. Oh, he isn't damaged to the enemies. Enemy is real. He just jumped to the Kasajin. And enemy won this fight. He's only survived. And he tried to kill. Oh my god, this damage. Was charge of ultimate. Ah. This damage was not enough, but it's pretty good damage. My god. But was not enough to kill this karma, and his full team is dead. It's pretty strange. Both they died for nothing. They lost Drake and they got nothing. Full enemy team is alive. So it was not a good fight for his team, but Viego was overstayed on the mid lane, so they got him. So okay, it's good. Now he again farming. And also guys, at level 16, his ultimate has a very short cooldown. And I think with his build, maybe he can deal a lot of damage to the enemies. Now they just farming. It's very good for Kasajin, cause if enemy just farming, he farming too, and Kasajin is late game machine. He's monster and he can pop them the late game. So it's very good if enemy wanna farm. And what he gonna buy in next item? It's very interesting. Another tanky build. Oh, he got stopwatch. So it means he gonna go for the Jonya. It's another survivability item. He's so, I think he's paranoid. He's trying to get so much armor items. He got Frozen Heart, Plate Steel Caps, Riftmaker for the sustain and health. And now he's gonna get Jonya. Oh my god, he one-shotted this Vayne, but oh, he finally got this karma. And also, oh, he was so close to survive, but this is real. Hit his heal and killed this Kasajin. And Jinx is alone. Oh no, it's not enough. And Jinx is dead. So it's pretty fine. Cause Kasajin got 2 kills. It's maybe good, but enemy can get Herald, or I mean Nashor. And it's very bad. If enemy will get Nashor, it's 80% to lose this game for Kasadin. And especially look at this difference. Oh my god, this total team goal difference and team score is really insane. His team so behind this trash Jinx, Nuno, Lucian, oh my god. He got Kraken Slayer and Last Whisper. It's pretty strange. So his team guys so behind. And how to win this game? Oh, he misclicked. He's his stopwatch for no reason. And it's really, guys, very hard to carry this game. Because when your team's so behind, it's really... You're just alone. When he fought in the fights, his team immediately is dead. So in the team fights, he's alone against enemies. His team literally can't do anything. The team fight. He's just dying and that's all. So really, I don't know how he would carry this. Now he just trying to get farm and level. It's very important for Kasadin to get level. And also, like I said, Kasadin is late game champion, so with items maybe he can try to win this game. Now he got 3 items, it's pretty good in this game. When his team so behind and he was against counter pick. Vega is AD champion and he is very strong in early game. So he played against counter pick and he won one lane and got a lot of farm. Oh, and now this Gwen. Oh, he trying to fight against this Gwen. Oh, she did a lot of damage to the Kasadin. But on this Hikarim, oh, this shield from Thresh, and the enemies tried to kill this Kasadin, but Kasadin survived because Thresh used his Solari with W and saved this Kasadin. So Kasadin now is alive, he killed enemy Gwen, and now he tried to kill this Israel, shut down for the Kasadin, and now they wanna try to get enemy Karma too. Oh, she wanna try to escape, but you can't escape from Kasadin. And now he got 10 kills, and it's really so good. And maybe this is compared. Oh, now they trying to get this Drake. Oh, this third Drake for his team, it's very good. One more Drake and this is Ocean Soul. Ocean Soul for this tanky Kasadin is really good. And now he's recalled to the base, he got a lot of kills. So what he wanna buy, it's very interesting. He got Dark Seal, maybe he wanna buy Magi. Or maybe he wanna upgrade this tier to the Seraphim. It's very interesting what he wanna buy. Because his build is pretty strange, yeah, he got this item, Seraph Embrace, for additional mana, ability power. So now he has 400 AP and it's pretty good, his spells deals a lot of damage. This Q damage, W, E, oh, this E damage, 500 magic damage, it's really insane. And his ultimate gives a lot of damage and also it can stack 4 times. So with max stacks he can deal with his ultimate 700 magic damage. Oh, the enemy trying to fight, but Kasadin dodged this Hikarim ultimate with his Jonya. And this Gwen survived at low HP. Oh, Jinx deal damage. Ah, not enough to kill someone. And also, guys, I think no. At max stacks, he has 800 damage. This mathematically correct Kasadin. So he tried to defense, his team lost the fight. And now they got two inhibitors and they also now try to get bottom tower. Kasagin jump to the Viega to kill Viega. Oh, Viega was pop. Shut down and Gwen, she's alone, she can't survive, and Jinx got this kill, so it's good. Now they saved this bottom side and it's so good. And this is additional kill for the his team. And maybe he can try to come back. Enemy team still has very good advantage. And has more kills and they try to pressure his team so much. But I think in the late game, look at this, Kasadin already level 16! Oh my god! So it means his ultimate cooldown. Oh! Look at this! 1 second! 27. Oh my god! At max stacks, he can deal almost 900 damage. So with this cooldown, if this cooldown, it's really insane value. And his team trying, no, they already got this, so his team don't wanna even defense this nature, so they just gave them this object. And Kasadin now got Magi, so I think it's was good time in the previous fight. And now he just stayed FK under his base. Oh, he got potion with mana. No, with HP and health. So now he trying to focus enemy Hikarim. Oh, he got a lot of damage, but finally he killed this Hikarim. Finally he got Gwen. And also enemy team can do damage to the Kasadin. Oh my god, guys, did you saw this damage from Kasadin? This is tank build. And enemy, look at this Viega damage. He can deal damage. He's like tank, but tank with insane one shot damage. This Kasadin is really built, it's pretty strange, but it works. Because enemy just can't kill this machine. He's so fat. He has a lot of armor. Oh my god, look at this number. He has a lot of armor. Only Gwen can kill him. And also he has insane damage with his ultimate. And also another spell deals damage, not bad. So it's really pretty strange. Cause he built in full tanky build. But he deals damage like player. Oh, look at this, is real. Oh, just popped. Just popped is real. Oh my god, and now he trying to kill this Karma. Viega can deal damage to the Kasadin. He just ignoring him like minion. He's like minion for Kasadin. And now he got 3 people from enemy team. But in this time enemy creeps trying to push his Nexus. It's not good. No one wanna defense this. Now he's gonna call to the base. Oh, so much creeps was there. Alright, now Jinx used her teleport. But he can get this creeps too. Oh, now also he got 25 Magi stacks. So he has so much AP. And his ultimate damage. Oh my god, his E damage. Oh my god, these numbers. Oh my god, his ultimate at max stacks deals 1000 damage. This cooldown less than 1 second. Oh my god. This is balanced champion or what? I don't know, but he's really so insane. And also look at this, he sold his boots and he got Cosmic Drive for additional ability power, health and ability haste, and also gives more speed. Not like boots, but anyway, it's pretty fine. And I think boots for Kasadin is not necessary because he has ultimate with this cooldown. You don't need boots with this cooldown on ultimate of Kasadin. And his team wanna try to pick up someone, I think. Enemy team playing very safe, so it's so dangerous to die if you die. Oh, he jumped to the enemies, now he's Jonya, so it's not good place for him, but he's so fat, he's not full damage build, and now he tried to focus enemy Gwen, enemy Hikarin's his ultimate, and now his flash ultimate to the Israel. Israel is one-shotted, Karva one-shotted, and this Gwen one-shotted, triple kill for the Kasadin, also Jinx killed this Hikarin, but she died, but Lucian and Kasadin is alive, so they just coming to end this game. It's pretty interesting cause he come back to this game, guys, due to sad this team score, and now his team still behind, but he absolutely won this fight without any troubles. He can tank a lot of damage from enemy team, and he can deal insane amount of damage, and now he don't wanna get this inhibitor, so he just use recall to the base. It's pretty interesting. And he coming for the blue buff, I think, yeah. Also guys, I think he can solve this Magi, and after that he can get death cap. Also, I think with the cap, he can get more ability power. And his ultimate, he deals so much damage. He need the cap, really, guys. I think he need to sell this item. This item also gives you more speed and ability and health. So maybe he wanna play with this item. Oh, someone used teleport to the bottom side. This is Viega, and Viega was immediately one-shotted. And now our Kasadin trying to kill this Hikarim. Hikarim is dead. Enemy team can't do anything against this Kasadin. He just using his ultimate, and that's all. His team trying to fight, but Gwen deals a lot of damage. It's not good. It's not good place to fight under tier 4 from enemies. They trying to defend this Nexus. And this Kasadin, oh my god, this Kasadin damage! Oh, finally Jinx was hit at this Israel, but this Kasadin just literally popped them, and he's so carried the game, I think. Because his team was so behind, he made 20 kills and really he carried this game. So guys, tanky build for Kasadin is broken. If you like this video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Also, you can write a comment about new videos on another champions. And now, have a nice day and goodbye.